everyone, namaste and assalamu alaikum. Hi, this is Maria Khan, your master teacher of biology here at Vedantu. And people, welcome to my session. We are covering the chapter circulatory system from our ICSE class 10. And today we are going to cover up the actual circulatory system of the blood in the human body. So yes, we are going to study about heart, the chambers of the heart, how the blood is circulated within the heart, how the cardiac cycle operates, the concept of blood pressure, pacemaker, everything. And people, I am super excited for today's session. If you are equally excited, hit on the like button, post me a you in the chats. Subscribe to our channel if you haven't yet subscribed, and let's get started. So people, this is a part of our Prodigy series, wherein under the Prodigy sessions, we cover up the entire chapter. So yeah, in the previous session, we covered up the composition of blood, right? And then I asked a question. So here, Gautam answered it first. So he said, ki RBC, it transports oxygen to the body. White blood cell, it protects our body from infection and platelets. It prevents, a platelet helps in clotting up of blood. So yeah, people, Gautam said it right. And even Madhu. So Madhu has answered it, ki it helps in transportation of substances, right? And Bhumika has also completed the homework. So yeah, point number one, she mentioned it helps in transportation of gases, and it carries antibodies which are produced by white blood cells, and blood clotting factors which help in clotting up of blood. So yeah, perfect. So these three are my official Chintu candies. So congratulations, my kiddos. And what are the contents of the session? So point number one, we are first of all going to study heart, then the blood vessels entering the heart and leaving the heart, veins which are present in the heart and the blood vessels associated with the heart, circulation of blood in the heart, okay? Then comes heartbeat and pacemaker, okay? So chalo, without wasting any further time, let's get started. So people, the circulatory system comprises of three prime components: heart, blood and the blood vessels, right? So people, under the blood vessels, we have three main type of blood vessels: arteries, veins and capillaries. So people, arteries divide and redivide to form arterioles. Arterioles divide and redivide to form capillaries. Capillaries join and rejoin to form venules. Venules join and rejoin to form veins. So yeah, arteries, arterioles, capillaries, venules and veins. So yeah, these are the blood vessels, and we have already covered up the concept of blood. So today we are going to study about heart. So where is the heart? So people, heart is located right over here within our chest cavity, called as the thoracic cavity. Now heart is protected by a rib cage. It is placed securely in between the two lungs, okay? Now placed in the center with its apex tilted towards the left. As its apex is tilted towards the left, we say that heart is actually towards the left. But to be very honest, heart is right here in the center. Its apex is slightly tilted towards the left. Okay. So people, the contraction of the heart is so powerful at the apex that it gives a feeling that heart is on the left side. But no, heart is in the center of the thoracic cavity. Now, surrounding the heart, there is a protective layer called as the pericardial membrane. Rather, there are two layers of pericardial membrane, okay? So, outer pericardial membrane and the inner pericardial membrane. In between these two layers, there is a fluid called as the pericardial fluid, okay? So, when the heart beats, okay, when the heart beats, there can occur a friction between the heart and this pericardial membrane, because of which the pericardial membrane may get damaged. So to prevent this frictional damage, there's a pericardial fluid, okay? So pericardial fluid, it actually reduces the friction, okay? So yeah, it's a double membrane pericardium. How big is your heart? How big is your heart? Nadil bohat bada hai. Na people, it is the size of just a human fist, okay? So size of a closed human fist, and dimensions 12 into 9 centimeters, so 12 centimeter in length and 9 centimeter in width. So if this is the size of my fist, so my size of the heart will be corresponding to the fist size of mine, okay, to my fist size. So yeah, it is likewise for everyone. So internally, if I see the vertical section of the heart, okay, so there are four chambers, four parts within the heart. Each part is called as a chamber. The upper chambers are called as atria or auricles. The lower chambers are known as ventricles. And then there are two sides, right side and the left side. And that's the reason why there are total four chambers. The upper right one is the right atrium. The upper left one is the left ventricle. The lower right one is the right ventricle. And the lower left one is the left ventricle. So right atrium, right ventricle, left ventricle, right atrium, right ventricle, left atrium, left ventricle. So there are four chambers present within the heart. Okay. Now if you see carefully, the walls of the atria, okay, let me change the color, okay, the walls of the atria, they are very thin, but the walls of the ventricles, they are actually very thick, okay, because when the atria contract, the blood enters into the ventricles, but when the ventricles contract, the blood moves out of the heart. In order to ensure that the contraction is really strong enough, the walls of the ventricles are really very thick. Okay. So yeah, ventricles have thick walls as compared to the atria. Okay. Now people, let us talk about the blood which is received by the heart. Now the right side of the heart always receives deoxygenated blood. The right side of the heart always receives deoxygenated blood. Now if you carefully see, this is the right atrium. So the right atrium receives deoxygenated blood from two big blood vessels, namely superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. Okay, superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. So people, the superior vena cava brings in deoxygenated blood from superior body, that is heart and above. So it receives from the superior body, that is heart, chest and arms. So superior vena cava brings in the blood from the heart, chest and the arms, whereas the inferior vena cava brings in deoxygenated blood from the inferior body. And when I say inferior body, so here it is the abdomen and the lungs, okay, and the lower part of the body. So yeah, lower limbs. So yes people, superior body and inferior body. So people, the deoxygenated blood is first brought into the right atrium. From the right atrium, it moves into the right ventricle. Okay, clear? Perfect. Now people, moving to the left side of the heart. Now the left side of the heart always receives oxygenated blood. Okay, and that's the reason why it is represented with a red color. Now people, deoxygenated blood is dark red in color and oxygenated blood is bright red in color due to the presence of oxygen. Okay. Now, for our ease of understanding, we have color-coded it like deoxygenated blue color and oxygenated as red color. Now, people, the left side of the heart, that is the left atrium, it receives oxygenated blood. So, people, there are four blood vessels which bring in oxygenated blood from the lungs. Okay? So, which are they? See, 1, 2, 3... and 4. So they open it over here, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this four blood vessels, namely pulmonary veins. Okay, pulmons means pertaining to the lungs. So the blood vessels which come from the lungs are known as pulmonary veins. So these pulmonary veins, they bring in oxygenated blood into the left atrium. From the left atrium, the blood further passes into the left ventricle. Okay. So now that we discussed the blood vessels entering into the heart, now let's talk about the blood vessels leaving the heart. Okay. So always remember, the blood vessels enter into the atria and they leave through the ventricles. Atria mein entry, ventricles se exit. Atria mein entry, ventricles se exit. So people, from the right ventricle, there appears a T-shaped blood vessel. Can you see this T-shaped blood vessel? Okay. So this T-shaped blood vessel is none other than the pulmonary artery. Pulmonary artery carries deoxygenated blood to the lungs so that it can be converted into oxygenated blood. It carries the deoxygenated blood for oxygenation to the lungs. Okay, now people, this deoxygenated blood gets oxygenated into the lungs and then it is poured with the help of four pulmonary veins back into the left atrium. Okay, now people, let's talk about the blood vessel leaving the left ventricle. Now from the left ventricle we see a big largest artery of the body. Can you see this largest artery of the body? This largest artery of the body is known as aorta. So people, aorta supplies oxygenated blood to all parts of the body. It is the largest artery of the body. Okay, now people, if it is supplying blood to all parts of the body, there must be some blood vessels supplying blood to the heart itself, right? So the blood vessels which supply oxygenated blood to the heart are called as coronary arteries. Okay, so right at the base of the aorta, from where the aorta emerges, there are blood vessels, two big blood vessels which are entering into the right and the left side of the heart, called as the coronary arteries. They supply oxygenated blood to the heart. Okay, and then people, if we talk about coronary veins, so coronary veins bring back deoxygenated blood from the muscles of the heart. Okay, so yeah, two coronary arteries arise from the base of the aorta which supply oxygenated blood to the heart, and coronary vein, it collects blood from the heart and pours in into the right atrium. Okay, very very easy, am I right? Yeah. Now people, at times there can be blockage in the coronary artery. Okay, there can be blockage in the coronary artery leading to the deadening of the heart muscles. If oxygenated blood is not being supplied, the heart muscles may begin to die, and this particular medical condition when the person experiences is called as myocardial infarction, which in layman's term is known as heart attack, right? Now at times people experience a shooting pain in the chest region, okay, and this pain is called as angina pectoris. Now what is the meaning of angina pectoris? Now the chest pain experienced by an individual due to insufficient supply of blood to the cardiac muscles. The pain induced by insufficient supply to the cardiac muscles is known as angina pectoris. And when there is insufficient supply of blood to the heart and the heart muscles begin to die, the person experiences heart attack, that is myocardial infarction. So people, if you're understanding and enjoying every bit of the session, hit on the like button, share this video with your friends, post me a you in the chats, and let's proceed further. Now people, let's talk about valves. Okay, so what are valves? Valves are flap-like structures which open only in one direction, only in one direction. So people, these valves, they prevent the backflow of blood. Valves are present to prevent the backflow of blood. Okay, so between the right atrium and the right ventricle, there are three flap-like structures, something like this. Okay, and each flap is called as a cusp, and that's the reason why it is called as tricuspid valve. So tricuspid valve ensures that the blood flows from the right atrium into the right ventricle. Okay, that's one thing. Now people, bicuspid valve. Now people, there are only two flaps, two cusps, and that's the reason why the valve present between the left atrium and the left ventricle is known as the bicuspid valve. Now people, bicuspid valve is also known as the mitral valve. Now tricuspid or bicuspid, they both are collectively called as atrioventricular valves because they ensure that the blood flows from the atria into the ventricles. Okay, vice versa it will never happen. Yeah. Now people, are there any more valves present in the heart? So yes people, right over here in the left, sorry, in the right ventricle, okay, from where the pulmonary artery emerges. Okay, so at the junction of the pulmonary artery and the right ventricle, there is a valve called as the pulmonary valve. Simply, it is present in the pulmonary artery, and that's the reason why it's known as the pulmonary valve. One more valve is present in the aorta at the junction of aorta and the left ventricle. There is valve called as the aortic valve. Okay, so valves ensure that the blood flows only in one directional, unidirectional flow of blood. There is no back flow of blood. So people, here is the entire structure of heart at one glance. So four chambers: right atrium, left atrium, right ventricle, left ventricle. Between the atria and the ventricles, there's tricuspid valve and bicuspid valve respectively. So people, two big blood vessels, namely superior vena cava and inferior vena cava, pour in the deoxygenated blood into the right atrium. From the right atrium, the blood enters into the right ventricle. From the right ventricle, it enters into the pulmonary artery, which carries the blood to the lungs for oxygenation. Then the oxygenated blood from the lungs is brought in by four pulmonary veins, right? Four pulmonary veins. Now the blood is brought into the left atrium. From the left atrium, the blood enters into the left ventricle. From the left ventricle, it enters into the aorta, which is the largest artery of the body, and aorta supplies oxygenated blood to each and every part of the body, right? So that's the circulation of blood in our body. Now people, there are two steps involved in heartbeat. We all know when it is pertaining to the muscles, muscles perform two actions: contraction, relaxation. Contraction, relaxation, right? So now people, the contraction, the phase of contraction is known as systole, and the phase of relaxation is known as diastole. So contraction, systole, relaxation, diastole. Contraction, systole, relaxation, diastole. Okay, so there are two steps, two phases in the heartbeat: contraction and relaxation, systole and the diastole. Okay, so people, when we talk about the time period of a heartbeat, so first of all, the atria will contract, which we call it as atrial systole, which lasts for approximately 0.1 seconds. Okay, then people, the ventricles, when the atria contract, the ventricles relax, and when the ventricles get filled with blood, they are going to contract. So followed by atrial systole, there will be ventricular systole. So ventricular systole, it lasts for 0.3 to 0.35 seconds. Okay, so yeah, here it is, 0.3 seconds, the ventricular systole. Now, for some point of time, both the chambers will relax simultaneously, which is called as joint diastole, also called as the complete cardiac diastole. That measures for approximately 0.4 seconds. So if we like summarize it, it goes to 0.85 seconds. Simple as that. Okay, so yeah people, the time period of a heartbeat: contraction, relaxation. So atrial systole, ventricular systole, joint diastole. That is the heartbeat, which lasts for about 0.85 seconds. Okay, so people, the heart rate, the rate at which the heart beats, it differs for different individuals or different species, different organisms. Okay, not individuals, different organisms. And people, it is more or less related to the size of the body. Okay, smaller the size, faster will be the heart rate. It is inversely proportional. Okay, for example, the tiny little hummingbird, the heart rate in the hummingbird is tremendously higher than the elephant, which is so giant, right? It is also somewhat corresponding to the metabolic rate. Now, if the metabolic rate is high, in order to meet the increasing demands, the rate at which the blood is being circulated, that needs to be faster. And in order to encourage that, in order to fulfill that particular requirement, the fast heart rate is required. Okay, so in the textbook, there's a big table which refers to different organisms and their heart rates. So do follow it. Okay, now people, when the heart beats, there's a sound produced, which usually people call it as dhak dhak. There are so many Bollywood songs, right? Dhak dhak karne laga. So people, it's not actually dhak dhak. It is lub dub, lub dub, lub dub, lub dub, lub dub. Yeah, it's lub dub. So all those Bollywood songs, they should be like rewritten, hai na? So jokes apart, but yes, people, the sound, lub and dub, how it is produced. So when the atrioventricular valves shut, okay, when the tricuspid and the bicuspid valves, they shut, when they close at the start of ventricular systole, the sound lub is being produced, okay. And when the pulmonary valve or the aortic valve, when they shut at the time of ventricular diastole, that is the time when the dub sound is created, okay. So it is lub, dub, lub, dub, lub, dub, lub, dub, lub, dub. So people, there is a rhythm which is set in this heartbeat. Am I correct? There's a rhythm, right? And this rhythm is set with the help of pacemaker. So what is a pacemaker? Where is it? So people, the command, the message, the impulse which starts the heartbeat, that actually starts, arises from the pacemaker. So pacemaker is also called as the sinoatrial node, okay, also known as the SAN, SA node, okay. So yeah, SA node. So from here the message is triggered, the impulse is triggered for setting up the heartbeat. Now this travels with the help of specialized tissue. Now with the SA node, with the impulse from the SA node, the atrias will definitely contract. Now the ventricles need to contract, and this impulse must be transmitted. So this impulse is transmitted from this point, okay, SA node, which is right near the opening of the superior vena cava into the right atrium, okay, at the junction over there it is present. So from there, there are certain specialized tissues which are traveling, okay, which carry the impulse to this particular point. And this particular point is known as the AV node, atrioventricular node. So the message of the contraction of the heart, the impulse to set the heartbeat from the SA node is passed on to the AV node. So AV node is located very close near the tricuspid valve, okay, near the tricuspid valve, in between, very close to the interatrial septum, okay. Suppose this is a right atrium and this is the left atrium, so it is present somewhere over here. So yeah, here is the SA node and here is the AV node. Okay, so yeah, the impulse travels from the SA node to the AV node. Okay, now from the AV node, the impulse must travel down into the ventricles. So if it has to travel down into the ventricles, so there is interventricular septum. There's a wall in between the two ventricles, which is known as interventricular septum. So over here, okay, some dense muscle fibers are running which carry the impulse, which are called as the bundle of His. Okay, so yeah, they carry the impulse, and then from this bundle of His, numerous branches, branching fibers emerge, okay, which are called as the Purkinje fibers. So see, this Purkinje fibers, they cover up the entire ventricles. So see how the impulse travels from SA node to AV node, from AV node to bundle of His, from bundle of His to the Purkinje fibers, and that is how the pace is being set. Okay, so yeah, this is the pacemaker which sets the pace for the heartbeat. And finally people, we come to the concept of blood pressure. Now people, when the heart contracts, the blood enters into the artery, and therefore the pressure of blood in the arteries will definitely be higher, relatively higher as compared to the veins. So when measuring the blood pressure, we always measure the pressure experienced by the walls of the arteries. Okay. Now, this pressure experienced by the walls of the arteries will be greater when the ventricles contract, right? That is when the blood is being poured out, and it will be comparatively lesser when the ventricles relax. So the pressure in the arteries during ventricular systole will be comparatively higher as compared to the ventricular diastole, that is relaxation. So people, this blood pressure is measured pertaining to the arteries, pertaining to ventricular systole and ventricular diastole, and it is measured using an instrument known as sphygmomanometer. Okay, and in this sphygmomanometer there is a mercury column. So the normal blood pressure value is 120 by 80 millimeter of Hg, that is mercury. Yeah, so that's the concept of blood pressure. So people, I hope you are enjoying studying with us. If you are enjoying, hit on the like button, share this video with your friends, subscribe to our channel and post me in the chats. And people, if after experiencing the goodness of this particular session, if you are willing to join Vedanta, I will say don't have a second thought. Join us ASAP and gain 100% knowledge and 100% marks. People, there's Vedanta's improvement promise in place, which says that you've enrolled with us for one academic year, you will definitely see an improvement in your scores. And if there's no improvement, we'll return back your entire course fee. No questions asked. So people, it is one of a kind of promise. Grab the deal now. And I'll be briefing you about that particular promise very soon. So stay with me. Don't go anywhere. Okay. Now, people, when you enroll with us, you get unlimited access to live classes for the various subjects, like whether it's maths or science, you get unlimited access to our live classes. Okay. And then in each of our class, there are fun high level quizzes, much amazing than the mentee sessions. I know you all enjoy mentee sessions. So mentee say be amazing quizzes are there in each and every session of ours. Besides that, people, you get an opportunity to compete with students across the globe. When you participate in the quizzes, you get to see fastest fingers list, you get to see the leaderboard, you get to see the overall class rank and the points that you have earned. You actually enjoy the real competitive feel. And this is super amazing. Okay. And people, we do understand that you may miss on certain sessions. No worries. You can always watch the interactive replays. That is, even while watching the replays, you can play amazing live quizzes and you can get to see your name flashing on the leaderboard as well. So it is a replay, but not like a replay, something very unique, amazing, interesting. Yes or no? Yes, it is. And people, usually kids are stressed out for two reasons. One, notes. Two, doubts. So people, for every session we provide you a premium downloadable handwritten notes provided by the master teacher. So no need to hunt for the notes here and there, any of the reference books or any other publication. Simply, our handwritten notes are just a single click away. So whatever PPTs, whatever content that we use, we provide it to you in the form of a downloadable PDF with all the annotations, So what else do you need? You need doubt solving. So in each of our session, there is a master teacher who will be delivering you the content, but at the same time, there will be a classy class teacher who will be resolving your queries on the go. So yeah, people, grab the deal now, because when all your doubts are being resolved, you get a better understanding. And I will be showing you the actual session of mine where the doubts are being resolved and the ratio of doubts asked and doubts resolved. I'll be showing you everything. Okay. So yeah, in class doubt solving, and there are various assignments that we provide you, chapter based assignment, session based assignment, numerous test, monthly test, chapter based test, mid-yearly test, annual test, so many tests. And when you repeatedly attend these tests, you actually ace in your final performance, that is your board examination, isn't it? Yes, people. And along with all these benefits, you again get an opportunity to avail free unlimited micro courses and crash courses. So people, basically crash courses are those short term courses wherein you can enroll for maybe academic or non-academic topics. Like if I talk about non-academic, it can be personal development, how to speak English fluently, how to prepare for any kind of competitive examination, whether it's an Olympiad or NTSC or foundation batches. So yeah, there are so many different courses available here at Vedantu, absolutely free of cost. Okay, so people, the benefits that you avail over here, they are really, really, really huge, and the price that you pay is very nominal. So yeah, people, grab the deal now. How will you grab the deal? People, click on the link which has been put up in the description box, which has also been pinned in the comment section, and don't forget to apply my coupon code, which will be definitely automatically applied. That is Mac Pro, M A Maria K for Khan Pro. All our courses are Pro, so yeah, Mac Pro. M-A-K-P-R-O, Mac Pro. So people, when you click on this link, you get to see your grade board and the academic year automatically selected. So chalo, let me actually demonstrate you and show you this particular interesting thing. Hai na? So yeah, this is the YouTube video of mine, okay, wherein I taught you cell cycle and cell division, right? So people, over here, if I like scroll it further down, okay, so can you see this pinned comment? Click on this pinned comment, and when you click on this pinned comment section, so see, Grade 10 ICSE 2022 is automatically selected. Now when I further scroll it down, you can choose your plan from Pro Lite to Classic to Plus, whichever you want. Now all the basic features of Vedantu, like unlimited live classes, unlimited in-class doubt solving, study material assignments, personalized report cards, interactive replays, all these basic features you can avail with a Pro Lite subscription. And the VIP, Vedantu's improvement promise, is applicable with the annual subscription. So with my coupon code in place, the annual subscription would cost you ₹27,499 only. So yeah, people, with my coupon code, you save additional 10%. So that's huge. And you can opt for the EMI option, which starts at just 2,287 per month only. That's pretty nominal. But still, I will recommend you, ki beta, try out a 1 month course, which is costing you just ₹2,340 only. Pretty nominal, isn't it? Yes. Now people, with all these basic features, if you want a doubt solving app on your mobile phone, so you can opt for the Pro Classic subscription. Okay, Pro Classic subscription. So Pro Classic subscription would cost you ₹2,970 per month, and annual subscription would cost you ₹35,099 with my coupon code. Okay, and then if you want that there should be a personal mentor, a study buddy, a guiding angel who will be resolving, catering to your academic and non-academic concerns, helping you in doubt solving, motivation, timetable, planning, time management, everything. So you opt for the Pro Plus subscription, and the monthly subscription would cost you ₹4,230 only, and annual subscription with ₹50,399. That's it. So people, I guess now that you have made your mind, you scroll it further down and purchase Star Pro. This particular bracket will be visible to you, and I will say, beta, the Pro Lite subscription is more than enough. Okay, and you always have the option to upgrade your subscription, so no worries on that particular ground. So yeah, offer the Pro Lite subscription, and you can try out it for a month, as I said. So 2,340 only. And people, this price is pretty nominal. You know why? Because you are getting unlimited micro courses. Otherwise, outside students need to purchase it. But for you, it is absolutely free of cost. So let's assume, let's consider it as a round figure, like 2,000 is the course price. And if you are attending even 200 sessions in one particular month, so the price comes down to only ₹10. So ₹10 per session. Now people, we end up spending more on maybe a bottle of Bisleri or a packet of Maggi or a packet of chips or a biscuit or anything like that. So yeah, people, grab the deal now. Okay, and our new batches are starting really soon. Now the next question you will be thinking, wondering, ki ma'am, you are saying, why do we believe? I will give you a reason to believe. Okay, so see, this is my dashboard. There will be your dashboard as well once you enroll. So yeah, here are the upcoming sessions. Under my session, you can see upcoming sessions. So if I choose onto the past sessions here, When I click on Get Notes, I can download the particular session notes in the form of a PDF. Okay, see, the PDF is being like downloaded. Okay, it's being loaded. It's taking a bit time. Okay, blame my internet. Yeah, it's being loaded. Okay. Yep. So see, the PDF is ready. So yeah, page one. See, all the diagrams, all the handwritten notes, everything that we provide in the session is available for you to download. Okay, just a single click away. Acha. If you want to watch the recap 1 time, 10 times, 100 times before your examination revision session, if you have missed it, so you can just simply click on the replay button. Okay. Now, people, when you click on the replay button, you simply play the video. Okay. And over here. Okay. So, main kya kar rahi hun? Yeah. So, people, here, when I show you the particular video, see, you can see the video. You can download it and you can watch it n number of times. See the diagram which I have sketched. I actually teach you how to draw the diagrams, and then even we summarize it. See, this is a table wherein I have provided you the brief summary. So yeah, this kind of elaborate sessions we conduct. And on YouTube sessions, I can't unmute you, I can't uncam you, I can't interact with you one-on-one. But in all our live sessions on Vedantu's platform, it is all possible. So people, I will simply say, grab the deal now. And now that the CBSE guideline is out, ICSE guideline will soon be out, and that's the reason why, people, grab your seats now. And this Vedantu improvement promise only applicable till 30th of August. Okay, so yeah, this particular promise says that we provide guaranteed improvement in your performance if you enroll with us for an entire academic year. The only condition we have is you have to mandatorily attend 75% of the live sessions and the test that we assign, 75% test. That's a benchmark. Yeah. So people, if you are enrolling, you will definitely attend and you will definitely complete the test. Yes or no? And then the promise is assured. So yeah, people, grab the deal now. And the batches, as I mentioned, starting from 19th and 12th of July for class 9 and 10 respectively. So yes, people, click on the link in the description or in the pinned comment section and grab the deal now. And you know my coupon code, that is MacPro, is going to fetch you 10% additional discount. So yes, people, I hope you enjoyed the session. And now here is the today's homework. So people, what is a pacemaker? Post your answers in the comment section. And if you really enjoyed the session, share your feedback in the comment section, or alternatively, you can write down to me on my mail address, that is maria.khan@vedantu.com. And that's it for the day. Thank you so much, people, for being with me right till the end of the session. Let's meet in the next session. Till then, Allah Hafiz, Allah Hafiz, and keep watching Vedantu. Bye bye. Love you all. Take care.